Initially, the e-books project undertaken by the Ministry of Education covered just a few subjects to meet the needs of some third form students, but it has been expanded to provide more than 15 subjects offered by CXC. This means that students are now well equipped to study online and write CXC examinations. The ministry is also making sure that all students in homes with no connectivity get connected through MiFi. It's a portable device that works as a mobile Wi-Fi hotspot to allow laptops and other devices that do not have a portable cellular device to connect to it, enabling them to access the network.
Moreover, we have gone further still because we recognize some homes have no connectivity. And I really want to thank NTRC, my colleague Minister Guy Joseph, and the telecommunications companies for partnering with us to provide what we call MiFi devices or portable Wi-Fi so that we could ensure there is some connectivity in homes that either cannot afford internet access or are in remote areas.
The ministry has also expanded its school feeding and transportation subsidy to underprivileged children. The two programs have been in operation for some years, but after many parents lost their jobs during the COVID-19 outbreak, the ministry saw the need to increase the allocation to include the needy parents.
After 2 or 3 years of piloting the feeding program in secondary schools, we've been able to expand that offering, especially at a time like this when many of their parents would have lost their jobs. So thank you to the school feeding program team for recognizing that we need to beef up our efforts to meet those who now need the support that perhaps previously they would not have needed. Similarly, with respect to the transportation subsidy and busing students to and from school, we have had to move in areas where previously there was no such support, but because of this emerging class, the new poor, those who have been recently rendered unemployed, we have to cater to their children as well.
On Friday, the ministry announced that all schools on the island will be closed for 1 week except the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, CCSS, which will remain closed for 2 weeks. This will allow for the completion of contact tracing exercises after a student there tested positive for the coronavirus. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.